Coming up on Smart, we'll be creating an historic-looking batik using wax and paint. Kirsten uses the latest satellite technology to plough an artistic furrow. And East meets West as we create a citadel of sponges.
Welcome to Smart.
And I'm Mark Speight. So why should you be watching Smart today?
Well, it's creative, it's fun, it's inspirational, and it's very, very cool.
Here we are on Smart TV. My name's Mark Speight, a.k.a. Speighty.
I'm Kirsten Doggy Dog to you out there. Do you have an art problem you'd like to share? We cruise through the show, so much to see. Arctic Monkeys, Wicket, make Sam a homie, Mike Key.
My name's not Betty, they call me Mike Fischetti. I'm the king prop maker. I know cake baker.
If you're smart and like art, it's the place to be.
We got makes, throw shapes, doing something sporty.
We got a very special guest off of the TV.
Ed Petrie.
One thing left to do, it's my favourite thing. Big up the smartest, let me see you rock your bling. Oh, I'm going to look forward to that.
Ooh. That should be good.
Yeah, it's going to be good.
I'll just embarrass myself.
Warm me up for the show. Let's do some art, shall we? I've got some nice bright crayon colours here and a piece of paper that I've started my drawing on, and I'm just going to colour this person in here.
Kirsten, I'm so excited. I got your message about the boutique.
Whoa.
Look, I got new threads, new look, et voila, new Speighty.
Hiya, Rocket Man. I didn't say boutique. I said batik, as in the ancient art form we're about to do a version of.
Right. Okay, got it wrong again.
Yep.
Should we just crack on?
Yep. You're keeping the jacket, are you? Do you want to just join in with some crayon?
So what are you doing exactly?
Well, just colour in the body in nice bright colours. Well, the clothes
in the wax crayons,
colours,
yeah?
Yes. And then okay. The limbs do red. As long as they're nice bright colours. And another tip here is to press quite hard.
Oh, okay.
So you need loads of crayon on there. Of course, in actual batiks, what they do is they use wax. And they put it onto a fabric, a piece of material, rather than a piece of paper. Ah. And even the background. And you see how I'm really pressing on like that? That's going to take ages to colour the whole background in. So I have done one already. Let's just have a look at this. See how bright it is when it's finished? Really nice,
that
bright colours.
Lush.
Do you like the look of that?
I love that, yeah.
I really, really like it, actually. It's glorious. And what I'm going to do now is that.
What are you doing?
Do you want to go?
No!
Come on, get in, it feels good!
You
do it!
Fool!
Go on, really, scrunch it!
Well, you just
trashed it. It's actually part of the artwork, because what's happening is it's scrunching, and that causes the wax to crack.
Are you sure about this?
Yes, lots of scrunching there.
Right.
So when you open it up, the wax in places and some of those creases will have sort of cracked away. Probably can't see much of it now, but I'll be able to demonstrate it better.
Okay.
Move that out the way, and now cover this in black paint.
So you've aged it, is that what you've done by creasing it up?
Well, sort of. I've just basically, as I say, created little spaces for this black paint to go in, but you can't tell that yet. Do you want to join in?
Yeah,
I this.
You are absolutely just obliterating it.
So you're now thinking, hang on, they've showed us how to make a picture, scrumple it up, and then go.
Well, I've actually just given up at this point.
But don't panic, because over here I have got a tub of water and a sponge, and what I'm going to do now is just wash this water off. Will you just hold the thing now as I start to just wash it? Can you see now?
Yes.
Isn't this beautiful as you wash it off? Can you see? Isn't it a good effect?
It's going to all the nooks and crannies.
Yeah, so that's what would happen with the material that if you put a dye into it. Ooh, sprayed that everywhere. Do you want to see the finished product?
Yeah.
Let's put it down.
Genius,
Kirsten.
That's beautiful.
Isn't that great?
Oh.
So you see it's kind of gone back in time.
Yep.
Aged it a little bit. And you can go back in time to little eras like that there. Egyptian times.
Oh, Nefertiti.
Yeah, with the same effect. Looks good, doesn't it?
Yeah. Wonderful, that.
I'm now covered as well, which is always good to have a messy make.
I'm going
to
get changed.
Hey, Mikey Mike Fischetti,
hey,
what
there
are you going to make for us today from the US of A?
Well, from stuff, I'm going to create an object that represents Native American families and their stories.
Intriguing.
Yeah.
Just roll his titles. Mike's American.
American
Dream. Oh, Ben, put me out of my misery. What exactly is it?
Well, from stuff, I'm going to make an all Native American totem pole.
Totem, derived from the Ojibwe word, ododem, meaning his kinship group.
You're well informed.
Yeah, you mean totem pole, a monumental sculpture carved from wood, usually cedar, first constructed in America in the 1700s.
Yeah.
So you mean totem poles that sadly don't last over 100 years because the wood rots?
Yes, yes, that's the one.
I don't know anything about them.
Every time.
Do you know one thing, Mikey? You're going to need three smartest. You've got six
three?
Of them,
isn't it?
Okay,
three?
Yeah. Three this time.
You've got six of them. Who's it going to be?
Okay, let's take a look.
Who are you going to go for then? I like the green top, the number three.
I do like that. Oh, three's good. We'll take three. Oh, the two at the end. Definitely. Three, five, and six.
Three, five, and
six. They look exciting.
What a great choice.
Yep.
Lovely. Well, get on with it then.
All right, come on, smartests.
Not a hope.
Not a chance. Okay, guys, it's challenge time.
Right. Ooh,
brilliant.
You go, Crust.
Thank you. Very mysterious of you, Spatey. You'll travel by car using a satellite navigation system. The first to arrive must create a giant piece of art.
Wait. Mine says you can travel by anything other than a car.
Yes.
Wait, she gets sat-nav.
Yeah.
Wait, that's not fair.
I'll see you there, loser. Bye.
Mark, I can win without sat-nav. How do I look up a British zip code, though?
Postcode.
Zip code.
Postcode, Mikey.
No, zip code.
Mikey, you're running out of time.
All right, bye. My manpower versus your driving power. The race is on.
Hello, Kirsten.
Go.
Welcome to sat-nav.
We're going to win this competition. Ah, oh, the chains broke. Sparky, you've been a faithful old friend, but you let me down.
Ben. Turn left at roundabout and proceed for 2 miles.
Hopefully, I'll beat Mikey.
Maybe you could help me. I'm trying to get to this address. Do you know where that would be?
I have no idea. I'm sorry, my friend.
All right, well, have a nice day. Thanks. All right.
Continue for 500 meters.
Taxi! Just my luck. I'm trying to get to this place. I don't actually know where that is.
It's right out of my area, mate.
Is it?
Right out.
No way. Thanks.
Your hair's not looking too good today, Kirsten.
What? I thought my hair looked great.
I could do this all day. Oh!
There's no sign of Mikey. Looks like I'm first to arrive.
Sore. All right, let's go. I don't even know where that is yet.
You have reached your destination.
Excuse me, I don't suppose you can help me. I'm supposed to create a big picture around here.
You found just the right place. My name's Paul.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
So you know what I'm supposed to do?
I do indeed. You've got to do a picture, anything you like, and we're going to create it in the field behind us.
Okay, how?
We're going to take your drawing, we're going to put it onto a GPS, and then we're going to design it out in the field with the tractor.
Oh, well, hang on. I've got sat-nav in the car. It's been playing up a bit, but shall I get it?
No, you can't. You can't use the sat-nav you use on the road. You've got to use a proper agricultural sat-nav.
Well, grab a sketch pad then.
OK.
All I can see is this massive tractor, so I suppose I better sketch that then, should I? Wheel.
Hello, Mark. It's Paul here. Now, Kirsten showed up. Absolutely no sign of Mike. But Kirsten's doing the drawing and we're ready to go. So you done it then?
Yes, I've finished.
How about that then?
So what do we do with that?
Get it on the computer so we can get it onto the handheld GPS.
Oh, well, this looks complicated now.
Well, it's not that complicated really. Come on, look. Well, first we've got to take a picture of your drawing. Are you ready?
Yeah.
That looks spot on. Okay, perfect. Now we've got to get it from here onto the laptop. Hang on a second.
Hey!
Yep, hey, there we go. And all we've got to do now is get it down onto the GPS. There we go, how about that, eh?
Now what? This is getting exciting.
Now we unplug it and we get on the tractor and that's when the action starts.
Come on then.
Okay.
Come on.
We got to find out where we are. Can you see the dot?
Yes.
You've been fiddling with it already, haven't
you?
It's gone red. Okay, let's see if we can find the circle.
I like that you've indicated, Paul. That's good. Release the spader.
Down in the ground.
Oi.
We have contact.
Okay.
Right, let's see. You tell me where to go.
Okay.
I want to try to keep my circle nice and round.
I
is brilliant. I just want to show that to the camera. Look. Yeah, you're still on track. A little bit left.
A little bit left.
Okay. Left. Is it doing a good job behind?
Yeah. Tilly's enjoying herself.
You still think we're on target?
Yes.
What do you reckon?
I think it's not bad for a first attempt.
Not bad for okay.
Look, we're bang on target there.
Well, you should be getting more practice
now. Yes, I veered us off slightly.
Okay.
We're right on course. Beautiful. It's a beautiful thing. Now, listen, in about 10 metres, you are going to do a 90 degree.
A 90 degree.
Handbrake turn.
Okay, a bit of braking.
Go, go, go.
Okay, are we in business or what?
Yeah. It looks brilliant. We're going to do a job swap. He's going to navigate, I'm going to drive.
That's it. Hey, okay.
Speeding up.
Yeah, you're doing good.
Where is Mike? He's missing me driving a tractor.
I don't
know.
Where's
Mike?
He's missing all the fun, isn't he?
What are the chances of that? A helicopter after the day I've had. I might actually be able to beat Kirsten. This is so cool. Let's go.
Jonathan, I don't know if you know about the day I've had. I had the worst day. See that right there? A little split in my chin. Yeah.
I'm gonna have a look behind me.
Okay, have a look behind you.
Oh, that's good.
Now you've got about 7 meters, 6 meters. We're doing it. I think we got it. Straighten up.
I like that.
Straighten up. We got it.
Wow. That is brilliant.
Ooh, what about it?
Hang on, my phone's ringing.
Hey?
It's Mike.
It's not.
Mike! Where are you?
We're coming in. We're just coming in towards the top of the tractor here. It's huge! That must be like 2 acres across or something.
We made that! Does it look like a tractor?
That is so cool. I can't believe she did that without me! Kirsten, here we go. We're coming in. Hey, I see you! There she is!
Mike, hey! How showbiz is that? What?
The worst day. No joke. Oh, don't hug me too much.
This is my main man, Paul.
I'm Picasso, but you can call me Paul.
Okay, Paul Picasso.
What does it look like?
From the air, it's the most amazing thing.
Is it really? Yes!
You guys did a great job.
Time for a bit of art now from me, Mark Speight, when I prove to you that anybody can draw. And to prove it, I have three smartists joining me. We have Harry, Elise and George. Yay! Bravo. And all the way from Spalding, we have Ethan on the webcam. Yay! Lovely. Now, have you all got your pens and paper ready?
Yeah.
Good. Now, oh, actually, the other day somebody said to me, Mark, can you draw a sportsman? I said no. Not because I can't, because at the time I was washing my hair. Because I'm worth it. Right, let's crack on, shall we? Sportsmen! Now, how do you capture a sportsman? Because, you see, they never keep still for more than a second. They're always on the move. So, I've come up with this little device. OK, they're called movement lines. If you see here, I've drawn a guy who's just scored a goal. If you look underneath, I've drawn a stick man in blue. Can you see that? That is the line of movement. So what you've got to do is attack the paper like a footballer attacks the ball, OK? So let's go for it. Let's draw a soccer player doing a scissor kick, OK? So we'll do a head here, like this, OK? And let's just do a little sweep. And another little sweep, and a whoosh. All right, guys, off you go. That's it. All right, Ethan?
Yeah?
Good, have you done your sweep and a whoosh?
I've done a stick man.
You've done a stick man, that's good enough for me. Right, okay, now you've done that, you've caught the movement, okay? Now we can fill it in and do all the tricky stuff, okay? So, start with his T-shirt, first of all. Let's just do a very stylized hand. Let's do another arm coming up like this. Okay, there's his little thumb there. This now becomes his other leg, which has knee, probably is about here. That's his calf muscle there. And we'll just put the ball just tucked behind his foot like that, because he's just about to give it a good boot. Trick is, you see, the more you practice, the better you get these. But the idea is just to really have a go at doing as many stick men in many different poses as you can. Let's give him a bit more of a mullet. That's fantastic. Now, just to give the impression this guy is launching off the ground, what I'm going to do here is put a little shadow underneath him like that. And there you have it. Bosh! There's a footballer taking a scissor kick. Brilliant! Guys, you all ready?
Yeah.
Right, let's have a look at your footy players. Wow! Oh, come on, studio, look at this! Genius! Ethan from Spalding, let's have a look at your soccer player. Oh, genius! Well, don't you see? There you have it. Anyone can draw sportsmen, why don't you have a go? More art from me, Mark Speight, next time. Hey, thank you.
Today on Mike's American Dream, we have allowed in the luxury of three smartest.
Here we go.
Maya,
Shayna. Oh, yes.
So, Mikey, you're going to try and create a Native American totem pole in just 5 minutes.
High five, American minutes, Mark. Come on.
Can you do it?
Yeah!
Heck yeah!
Well, you've got 300 stateside seconds on the clock. Any time starts now.
Yes. Box one, please. Box one. Here you go. Sophia, take that one. Box two. Maya, here you go. Box three. Shayna. Oh, not quite yet. Hold on, hold on. Let me tell you a quick tip. If you don't want your boxes to fall over once you've stacked them all up, which is what we're going to do, easy thing to do, cut the top off. You got a little basket. You can tape it right on top, and it fits just like that. You see? Let's take some of that tape. Hold on 1 second. You want to take, can you rip that off?
Yep. Let me rip off a piece. There we go.
Thanks. Give me another piece out, and we'll do that real quick. All right, the other tip, as you can see right here, we've got some X's cut out. Now, these things, we don't need staples, glue, or tape on this. The clever thing is, we just stick it in there. We stuff it in there. You'll see that in a second. All right, this is all done. Here we go. This is Shayna's box. Let's get started. Thank you very much. All right, so you can go grab some of that fabric. Yep, that's great. Let's do that right up here. Okay, let's take some of that. I'm going to grab some stuff, too. Oh, yeah, we got blankets. We've got fabric. We've got scarves. Let's try it off. Yep.
Sorry, four minutes left.
All right. You guys want to maybe...
I'm in, yeah.
Yes, thanks.
Oh, let's do this.
That's good. So, watch this. You can just stuff it right in there, and it sticks. That's really cool. All right, let's go. Let's make this one really, really good. Let's make this one the best one, besides mine. Okay, so we just fold up a couple things, try to cover the whole thing in fabric, guys. Fabric first, and then we'll pin on other stuff with these. Check this out. Clothes pegs. Instead of using staples, glue, or tape again, we can just pin on stuff with clothes pegs. Much cooler, much better, much more modern. Because, you know, like, a totem pole is a lot like a family crest. Before internet dating sites or blog sites, before you put your profile up there, this was how they did it way back then, the original kind. So you tell everyone about your family by making a big pole, kind of a sculpture. So that's what we're doing, right? Let's hurry up then. Okay, what if I leave you with this one? You're pretty much covered. So you need to start pinning on there. Don't forget about the personal stuff. Did you guys bring in personal things today?
Yeah.
Yep. Let's make sure we get those on there. Okay, here we go. All right, that one is good. I think you're ready to go. Maybe stick that in there.
Lovely.
My piece, I'm going to get started on that, right here. This one's going to be the top piece. The big one, the coup de grace. All right, here we go. Let's see, I love Christmas, so I brought in my own Christmas hat. That's going to go on top. Oh, I love these. These are my favorite glasses, like my big comedy glasses. Love them, got to have them on here. They make perfect eyes, see that? Here we go, clip those on there. Perfect. You could literally put anything on there. But look at that, I got scrunchies. They're going to be like eyes underneath there. Oh, hey, no, these are mine. I want those. Why don't you go find, they've got wings over there. Oh, and a beanie hat. That's a good one. Try and get that.
Need a mask.
Let me grab some of that stuff. All right, here we go. Look at that, a tie. Maybe that would work for the bandana. Here we go. Oh, yeah, that's looking good. Love it.
2 minutes, Mike.
Maybe a pin on a couple things. I need some clothes pegs. Or some clothes pegs. Oh, here we go. You guys start pinning stuff on. Pinning stuff on already. Here we go.
Pegs.
There we go. Kirsten, could you help Shayna just for a second?
Yes.
Because yours is looking really good.
Okay.
Let's get this one done.
What have we got going on here?
All right, I'm going to pin on some of these. I love cooking, so I'm going to pin on some oven mitts. Because you got to tell, like, what your favorite things are. That's the whole point. Oh, yeah. Oh, you know what's going to make this work? It's different materials and textures. Look at that. We've got all different kinds of things on there. All right. One more thing on there. Where's my other eye? I got another eye on there. All right, let's start stacking up, I think.
Start stacking up.
Okay. Yep. Let me move this. Here we go.
Oh, hello.
let's move it right
what
here.
What are you doing?
Cut a hole in the top so that... Oh,
there you
we
go.
Can fit it right there.
Oh.
Yeah, here we go. You got an old hat stand to stack it on there. So now we can kind of turn it around to find the best side. Which is your best
That's
side?
That's the best side.
That's a good side. That's good.
Yeah.
Let's stick that. Box two.
1 minute.
All right. Let's stack that one on there.
Go on, Mikey. Go for it.
Can you grab me the scissors? I need to cut a hole in that. Whoa. Scissors. Watch out. Careful with scissors.
It.
Oh, that's perfect. Look at that. What's
this
your best
the
side? This side?
One?
Oh, I can see the eyes. Really good, really good. Oh, that's good. Oh, look at that. You got your picture on there. That's perfect. Now we need this. Let's get those ladders in. You guys can try and add a few more things on it.
Watch out.
A little bit, last bit of dressing. Get up there.
Mine's a small one.
All right, I got to put my box on there. All right, here we go. Oh, my thing. Oh, well, let's
25
see.
25 seconds.
Oh. Look at that. I needed some wings. I got this fan. Check that out. See? Wings, fan, perfect. All right, stick that in there. We gotta get my top box on. Hold on, watch out. Move around.
Quick.
Move it. Oh, get it back on there.
Quick.
You need the ties.
One.
Stop.
Wait. Look, okay, one last thing. Make sure it's facing the front. Oh, yes!
Okay,
come on, guys,
Let's examine what we've got here. You talked us through your personal stuff,
yeah,
and then you've got a photo on here somewhere, haven't you? And these are your ballet shoes.
And that's the ballet shoes for Maya's, yep.
Yeah.
Okay, it's looking pretty cool as a totem there, but is he going to get
that's
pie in his eye?
Come on, guys, come on.
Let's find out, first of all.
Mark, stay away with the pie.
It sounds supervisor Pete's decision. Are you going to pass him, or are you going to fail him?
Look at this, though. It's impressive.
Oh, he's yes! You. Brilliant.
That's one pass, guys.
Next pass is another
on.
Pete. This time it's entertainment runner Pete. Are you going to pass or fail?
Come on. No! He is out of a job.
So that means it's in the hands of the smartest. Pete, because everyone's
called
Pete this week. No, smartest, what are you going to do? Are you passing or are
Remember
you failing?
We met earlier. No! No, I don't want to
fail.
Injustice!
Still to come on Smart. We polish off some fantastic art with an eastern city of sponges. And find out if your art's made it into the Smart Gallery.
Well, Kirst, this show's smart, but it's about to get smarter.
Oh, how?
Well, he's left Oucho in the office. Will you give it up for Mr. Ed Petrie?
Yay! Showbiz kiss, but I went for the showbiz punch.
Oh, Ed, I've got to ask you, what's it like working with a cactus?
It's a bit like working with Kirsten, really.
Oh, really?
Lots of shouting and gibberish.
Yep, I know. Sympathise. Nice one. Torch.
Yeah, thank you.
Did you stitch him up for that?
No, it's just purely.
Yeah, I was about to be nice and say, as well as being a brilliant, well, let's change it, average CBBC presenter, you are a bit of an agony ant, aren't you? You can solve art problems.
Yes.
And,
yes.
So we gave you one of Mark's art problems, and hopefully you've been able to solve it for him. Have you got the problem? Have you got the letter?
It's not really a problem, Kirst.
Is that the letter there? Come
no,
on, is
can't
that
stop it.
That's it. Brilliant. This is the letter. This is what you wrote.
What
tears
my eye?
Dear Auntie Ed, I have an art problem. When I paint or draw a picture, I just can't leave it alone. I keep adding stuff, changing stuff, and I generally won't admit when I've done enough. Can you help me? Mark Speight, smart presenter. What have you got for us?
Well, this is what I came up with, because I do like to make inventions to make the world a better place.
Mm-hmm. Yes, of course.
And it did upset me, Mark, that you have this problem.
Oh, bless you.
So I made this. It's the invention to help you know when to stop drawing.
Like it.
Okay, and so I think basically the time to stop drawing is when that little voice in your head says, oh, maybe I should add a bit more.
Exactly. That's exactly the time,
I think. So basically this machine reads your mind.
Okay.
Wow.
And then when it hears you say, I wonder if it needs a little bit more, then it stops you from painting straight away. And I thought the best way to grab your attention would be to have a robotic face of the scariest teacher I ever had, who was Mrs. Best.
Yes.
She used to frighten the life out of me. So her voice comes out of this big megaphone, she goes, stop that right now! And then her face bursts its way through the canvas.
Like that,
yeah, and
yes.
Stops you painting. Actually, I haven't just finished it off.
All right. Hang on.
Oh, that sort of would ruin your canvas then, though, if she burst through.
Well, then it would stop you, see? Stop you drawing.
There we go, and it's on caterpillar tracks to make it easily transportable.
It looks a bit like a fat Dalek now. Shall we have a little look at you in action doing what you do best, which I think is panicking?
Yes.
Right. I've just realised I've been completely wasting the entire afternoon. I'm supposed to be revising for my grade 2 presenter exam. Otherwise, I get the sack from CBBC. The exam's tomorrow, and I've done absolutely no work. Instead, I've been rearranging floors in the fifth order. I've been playing hoopla with a cactus. I've been doing the cleaning. I've been doing other people's washing. I've done no work at all. I'm going to fail. I'm going to fail tomorrow, and I'm going to be making tea on the one show. I'm having a panic attack.
Say it!
Bravo!
I've still got scars from that, you know, being slapped by a cactus.
Nice, yes. One from me as well. No, we should really make up. It's like we don't like each other. It's weird. Well, you know, you're a brilliant CBBC presenter. Oh. You're an amazing agony aunt, aren't you? You're president of the Rustington Train Spotter Society. I can't even say it. Society.
Thank you very much, Bruce.
That wasn't public knowledge, though, was it? Mm. Well, you know, you're a great artist as well, it would seem.
Let me be the judge of that, Kirst. Would you like to join me for a bit of pastel pleasure?
Oh, yes.
Come on, Ed, this way.
I never get to join in.
Now, Ed Petrie from CBBC Channel has agreed to do some art with me. It's very kind of you.
Oh, that's right.
I thought, on homage to Oucho, we'd do a little desert scene. What do you reckon?
Oh, we'd like that, yeah. I'll take that back to him in the office.
Oh, bless. So what I think we'd start with, first of all, is the, well, the Rockies, I suppose, wouldn't we? I'll do this in charcoal, so let me just...
Well, like the Grand Canyon kind of thing.
Yeah, that's it. That's what I meant, the Grand Canyon. So let me just do a little bit of a canyon going on there, a few little hills in the background. Just drag that across. Would you like to do a big cactus foreground? What do you reckon?
Oh, yeah. I've been drawing a lot of cactuses recently, actually. Yeah. Oh, Oucho likes it.
Oh, bless him. I do like Oucho. I think he's so cute. I reckon. Nice.
So you should I do a skull? There's always a skull in the desert.
Oh, you've got to do a skull, a dried out cow skull or something like that, yeah.
I do. I like drawing in pastels because they're very forgiving, aren't they?
Oh, they are. I mean, you can just smudge them and just start again, can't you? Which I think I might have to do on this one. So you're a trained artist, or is it something you just like doing? You know, your cartoon?
I think if I hadn't done acting and stuff, I would have probably been an artist. I'd like to have done, like, graphic art, something like that.
Yeah. So it's looking nice.
We're going to sort of colour it in a bit.
We need a bit of white in there, don't we, I think? Because I think the orange paper, you know, is nice and hot.
Mm.
You'd probably put a nice bit of...
Shall I put some on the cactus?
Yeah, a bit of white hot. So you also do stand-up comedy, don't you, as well?
Yeah, I do. I do stand-up for adults and I do it for kids as well, so...
And what's it like then, you know, facing a live audience like that?
I think it's good. Keeps you on your toes. Because I think if you work in telly, you have lots of people standing around saying, oh, you're wonderful, darling, you're wonderful, love you, yes, brilliant, brilliant.
Do you get that? I don't get that.
Well... In the CBBC office, it's just me and Oucho, so Oucho's always telling me I'm great. So I think it's good to do stand-up, because then, you know, you face a live audience, you get people sitting there with their arms crossed, occasionally going...
Now, that's true, actually.
Brings you back down to earth.
Yeah, true. Let's have a look at this. How's this going on? I think I might put a little bit, just a little bit. I'm just experimenting now. I think a bit of that in there. Does that work?
Ooh.
Do you think?
Yeah, I like that. That's good. It's the desert, isn't it?
Yeah, I might sort of separate that.
Chuck a bit of that in.
Chuck a bit.
I'm going to draw some flies flying around the...
Yeah, that's nice.
Flying around the skull's
head.
Make
it a bit darker as well, you know. I always get a little bit scared to go a little bit mad with charcoal. So you're only using three colours, really, but the orange paper, it sort of works, doesn't it? Don't you think?
Yeah, it's good. I wouldn't think to draw on coloured paper, actually. I normally just draw on white paper.
Yeah. It's a bit of a bold move, really.
Now, will I get to take this away with me?
Oh, you can have it if you want it.
Because you know what we do with pictures in the CBC office, don't you?
You don't shred them, do you?
Yeah.
Great.
If I show it to Oucho, he will want me to stick it in the shredder.
Right, well, on that note, I have to say, would you mind signing it?
Oh, go on then. I'm quite pleased with this, actually.
Feel the heat glowing off it, can't
you? Yeah, you can.
Lovely.
I'm sweating.
Thanks very much, Ed. Ed Petrie and his cactus scene. Thank you very much. What? Good work.
That looked lovely. Right, one of my favourite words is sponges, so I love it when I can do a picture using sponges. I've got loads that I've cut up into different shapes in there, and they're nice different colours, so it can be washing up sponges like this, or maybe sponges like this that you've got in your bathroom. It is time to clean up.
Well, I don't want to say anything, Kirst, but you are a bit whiffy.
No, not me. The make, we're using sponges, washing gag type
right,
thing.
Well, I'm ready to soak it up then.
Nicely recovered, actually. Quite good. So I've got a thick piece of card. We're just going to arrange our pieces. You've got a load there.
Oh, right, sorry, yes, of course. Oh, sponges!
Sponges, you see?
Sponges, fantastic.
Now, we're going for a cityscape, Mark, but not a kind of modern city.
OK.
You know, like the kind you might see in places like Tunisia?
Ah, OK, the little domed houses.
Yes, that's what these shapes are, you see. These are really, really simple to make, because you've already basically got the shape on the top of a bathroom sponge like that, you see.
Oh, so you just lopped it off.
Yeah, just kind of trim across, like so.
I like that.
Oh, keeping your fingers out the way. And one of the beauties is you can actually, once you've made a little hole like that, rip across. And same thing again, sort of cut in to halve it, because you don't want a big chunky picture. And then just tear across to get your right thickness. I nearly said thickness there, you
thickness.
See? And there you have a little piece, like so.
Okay.
Fairly cool, isn't it?
It's nice.
And you see how we've got these kind of bits? I thought they would be sort of steps.
Oh, right, okay,
that's
actually.
What I had
I know,
in my mind.
A few more of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll put another
sort
one in.
Build it up.
Yeah, lovely.
And you can layer them up as well. It doesn't have. Oh, you are. He's ahead of me.
As always.
Add that bit in there. Oh, actually, I'm going to trim that.
Lovely.
So, because we haven't glued anything down yet, you can just mess around and change where everything goes as much as you want. And when you are happy with it, just glue all of your cityscape bits down.
Nice.
And it'll come together in an amazing style, like that one has there, which looks completely cool.
I love the sky as well. Chalky, smudgy.
Yeah, all made from sponges. So that looks great, but you could take this one step further. If I move ours out of the way, once you have glued all your bits and bobs down, like this one here, I've got some household gloss paint in here. Do you want to grab a brush today?
Lush.
Give it a stir. Now, if you've got any of this lying around at home, careful, you need aprons on because this doesn't come out your clothes, but just sort of add it on to your picture. Paint the whole thing. Now, because it's gloss,
it soaks it up, doesn't it?
Yeah, but also it goes all sort of like real buildings would look. You know, like if...
Stone?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The holes in it soaks.
Can't believe you've got to make with sponges.
Like so. And you can even paint the background.
Okay.
Like that. That's an easy bit, isn't it?
There you go.
And you see, now it looks more authentic, like a kind of North African Medina that you might get, because they tend to have them all white, don't they?
Yeah, reflect the heat, I suppose, isn't it?
Yeah, I think that is why it is. Good fact.
Yeah, thank you.
So, once that's finished, you're quite pleased with that, aren't you?
I am, yes, pleased with myself.
It'll look like our one.
Oh, yeah, I've got it here. Look at
really
this beauty.
Lovely. This is what we're aiming for.
Isn't that wonderful?
Doesn't it look great? So the shine on the gloss, when you sort of tip it, you get the shadows in there as well. And it really does look like a stone effect.
It does work really well, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Like that.
Mark's mum gives us a fly idea to make with old jewellery. The art tips have some more top artistic advice for you. And today's alternative art challenge is really the icing on the cake.
I am so looking forward to this cup of tea.
Oh, me too, Mikey. Me too.
Me as well, but I could really do with a slice of cake to
that
go with
good.
It.
Oh, cake! Oh, I forgot!
Chewy!
Oh, my mom, she's going to kill me. Look, will you just cover for me? Where's my penny? I'll be back in a minute, yes.
Okay, bye.
What's a penny?
Chewy! Oh, I'm so excited! I told you I was excited! Where's my little cherubin?
Oh, he's just popped out.
Mike, do you know what day it is today?
A smart day?
Oh, give over! You Australians have got the wittiest sense of humour. No, you fool, it's my birthday! Oh. Come here and make it special.
Oh, no! Oh,
happy birthday, Mrs. S.
Well, where is he then?
Not here, is he?
He's forgotten, hasn't he? How could he? All I wanted was some expensive jewellery, and I've got this cheap old chat. Oh, come on, Frieda, pull yourself together. Don't let the viewers see the hurt. Suck it up, suck it up. Oh, I've had a smart idea. We could use this junk jewellery to make a picture. I've got loads of the stuff in here. Oh, I've never thought of that before, eh? You're looking lovely today, Mike.
Thanks.
Isn't he lovely? Look, here we go. We arrange it in a little line. That makes me come back a little. Oh, I've got this stuck on me. You can touch it.
I've had my hair done. Do you like?
What's she up and on about, Mike?
I don't know.
Have you had your hair done?
I have, actually, Mike. Thank you for noticing it.
Yeah.
Especially for you. To be special today. I do love him, you know. I do love him. Right.
Mate.
Okay. Now, what we're going to do here, right, we're going to arrange these into a little globule of eye shape, you see, because I thought we'd make a little dragonfly. Now, if I just put that around there, and I could use my earrings, you see. There's a pair of eyes here, look, you see. Look at that.
Oh, wow, that's nice.
Isn't that beautiful? He's got a third eye there. Actually, we'll have to excuse that one. Okay, I think what would you actually, we'll take that one off.
Use that one instead.
Yeah, you see, because what I want to do is put that one down there like that, you see.
curl it
round. Oh, the old figure of eight routine.
Look at that.
Lovely.
Isn't that beautiful?
That looks good.
So you could glue that down, couldn't you, if you used PVA?
I'm coming onto that, Christine.
Just dry clear if you...
Now, I've got some glitter glue pens. Would you like to do one as you start?
Yes.
Mike, would you like to do a little wing?
I would love
me?
To.
Oh, would you?
Yeah.
So just sort of...
Just squeeze it on. Squeeze it. Mike, I'll show her how to do it, would you? Look?
Okay.
Bless you. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, that's so special. Now, you see, what I would do, I would glue the body down with some PVA. Because it dries nice and clean. And also, it stays on the board.
Quite nice, that.
Oh, dear.
Oh, that's a good effect.
Isn't that beautiful? You've got yourself a lovely little picture all made from junk jewellery.
So that middle bit you could glue down and...
I've just said you could glue it down. She's got cotton wool in her ear. She really has. Now, listen, Mark's promised to take me and Betty out dancing tonight.
Oh, great.
Oh, I cannot wait to bounce my body on that dance floor. Right, I better go and put my face on. Oh, and Christine...
Yeah, Mrs. S?
Put your face on that. Happy birthday, Mark! Oh, where's she gone?
Oh, she's just gone to put her face on. Oh.
And prepare for your night out.
No, I think you'll find it's more like this.
Oh, yeah. Dear me. Oh, cake!
Oh.
Art in the smart gallery.
I totally agree. Now, here's the Arctic Monkeys.
Ahoy! Be you the Arctic Monkeys?
Well, the monkeys and assorted others, I'll tell you, back in my day, you'd have to qualify as a pirate.
Then prepare to meet your doom, you scurvy swags. I be Captain Jake Sparrow.
You be no sparrow, and it's your doom.
Is she a beautiful lady? I love beautiful ladies. I love beautiful ladies. No, you're doom. You're doom. I come from distant lands to eat your breakfast cereal, to run around, to look cause trouble.
I was going
to
ask where you're from. You've got a funny accent.
Are you Cornish?
Why did you leave? There are lots of ladies who love in Cornwall. Beautiful ladies. No, I'm not from Cornwall. The end is nigh. Prepare to be boarded.
I think this one's had a dodgy ham. Jerome, tip 733, if you will.
Don't buy a canvas. Simply stretch a dishcloth over a piece of cardboard and paint it with PVA glue.
Arr, beaten at the last. Right, retreat. Don't miss the last you'll see of Captain Jack Sparrow. Avast, behind.
Vast behind? Are you saying my bum looks big?
I couldn't afford a canvas, so I took their advice and I used a dishcloth.
Yeah, when stretched over a piece of cardboard and covered with PVA, it makes a perfect canvas texture so you can paint on it.
It really, really works!
Thank you, our tip monkeys.
Now on Smart, it's that time of the show we like to call...
Tracy Teacup.
No, it's Tracy Beaker. And no, it's not that part of the show. What is it?
Robin Hat.
Oh, you two. It's the Alternative Art Challenge.
Yes, we have split the teams in two like a big arty watermelon. Yes, in the green team, captained by Elise, we have Maya and George.
They're rowdy today in the yellows. Our team captain is Harry, right there, and joining him is Shayna and Sophia.
Settle down, settle down. Now, the aim of the game is to create the likeness of today's celebrity guest. But who is today's celebrity guest, I hear you ask?
Who is today's celebrity guest?
CBBC's Ed Petrie!
Doesn't he look lovely? Now, the team which Ed think has painted the best likeness will win the much sought after Smartest Art Challenge trophy.
Lovely stuff, but you know the form by now, it's alternative. So that means today you have to do your likeness using icing and spatulas, piping it on.
That reminds us of the Swiss painter and sculptor Alberto Giacometti.
He was born in 1901 and continuously reworked and erased his paintings, resulting in the creation of linear images of great depth and haunting beauty.
Yes, he used the same thin lines in his sculptural pieces, which are often made as plaster maquettes first.
Oh, the texture of the plaster is a bit like us making an image of Ed using spatulas and icing.
Well, sort of.
All right, art analysts. Ooh. Guys, you have until you hear this.
Let them eat cake!
To complete your pictures, okay? There you go.
All right, guys, are you ready? In 3, 2, 1, sculpt!
Go, go, go!
There we go.
Right,
let's get in there.
Oh, I'm
going
to get it on. Squeeze it on.
Get it right on.
Okay, look. Let me start off with his face. Okay, get a bit of green hair
squeeze
on there.
It.
Green hair. Lovely, yes. Squeeze.
Whoa! What?
Need a bit of beef in this, a bit of welly. No, what are you doing, love? Oh, what are you doing? I'll spread it around, okay? That's looking good. That's looking nice. That's looking nice. Don't worry. That's it. Don't worry. That's it. Lovely.
Why have you started so hard?
Okay, don't worry. Spread that. Start with his body, okay? Start with his body. Let's get his arms in.
What about the long bits of his hair, the dangly bits?
Oh, we need the eyes.
That's lovely. That's enough for his mouth.
Let's finish up his face.
It's fine.
Looking
good. Ears.
Okay. Well, you've changed your pose now. That's thrown them off.
Sorry. Mark. Here you go, Mark. If you want some white.
Yes. Oh, lovely. Thank you.
Yep.
Please, and to the sides of your pictures so we can see what Ed has to say. Ed, join us.
Right.
Okay. Yellows have...
I'm trying hard to look butch here. I like that. I didn't know my lips were so big.
Yeah, you've got a massive mouth.
I'm flattered though. I've got such a big mouth.
Got a side bit there and a nice little wave.
Yeah, I like that.
Lovely.
Ed, check out this beauty.
Wow.
Oh, nice, yes.
Tastes lovely as well. Try some of that.
That's real icing, isn't it?
Lovely.
Very good.
Yeah. So you've got to make it.
It's definitely tasty. It's definitely tasty.
Okay, what are you going to go with? Only one not contained.
I think they got the beehive nicely there.
Very textured as well, very textured.
Decision time. Are you going to go yellows? Or are you going to go green? You're going to do a little jig while you decide. Look at their little faces. And over here, they're just involved in eating.
Lovely.
What do you think?
I think it's yellows.
Trophy is yours. Congratulations, guys. Green's hard luck, hard luck. Everybody get together. It's the end of the show. That's all we've got time for.
Never mind. Well, thanks very much for watching. Thanks very much to our smartest. Mr. Ed Petrie.
Yes, and if you're smart, you'll go and do some art. See you very, very soon.
Bye.
It's time!
Yeah, hello.
What do you mean they can see us?
One man, one cactus, lots of stupidity. Ed and Alto kick off weekday afternoons, only on the CBBC channel.